Hi, I have here in my garden a space that I don't like the way that looks now, and I'm going to change it with a mosaic. And I will show you what you can do this mosaic. It's very simple, of course. You can do it with any available broken dishes that you have around the house. And also I will show you how you can create a cement container at the base of this display to make sure that everything looks better than it looks now. So I will show you how you can do it. So here I have the containers that will be for the display. And this is one of them. As you can see, it's kind of ugly, so I want to improve the look of it. And over there I have the other ones that I already kind of finished, so you will see the way that you can get this type of artwork immediately. So for this kind of mosaic, I have here leftovers from dishes that were broke, you know, inside, like in a house, or yeah, I got them from the friends or neighbors. So there are a few pieces here that you can work with. So here I have like glass kind of beads here, which are very nice. Or you can use, as I have here a little display, you can use few other pieces by themselves. So if you wish to start with this one, then place it in the middle, like I have here, this small plate. You can just grow from this center point and make the design over. Or you can incorporate any other small pieces that we have here. Will be fun and very nice for the kids to enjoy with this type of artwork, especially now when they will get bored and they don't have too many things to do. So for me here, I will just use here like a carpenter glue, this kind, which is very strong and very nice and very cheap kind of. You'll get a lot of like 3 little bottles for around $30. And here I will start to get like a focal point for my artwork. So I will just put a little bit of glue. I don't want to spend time to use each time to put the glue and put the bead and go again, because I'm losing time and the point is to have fun but not to get bored. So I can start here for like a centerpiece with this type of bead. And to make sure that, because here it's not straight, as you can see, it's in angle here, to make it look to stay straight, like I'm just using this underneath to be like a flat surface, and the beads are not coming down because of the glue. Now here I can build any other design that I wish. For example, those beads, I will just place them here. And again, any kinds of ceramic that you have available or anything that you wish to use for a mosaic, you can use it. It's a very versatile, so you can use in different ways to do this type of the work. Here I have another kind of piece of ceramic. Those are some specific nipples for the ceramic. They have an elongated point here and the flat one, and that will help me to break the ceramic. You have to use just the end of it. Don't go to the middle because it's going to work more for you if you will go to the end. The force to break the ceramic, it's better if you hold it for the end. So I will go just with few pieces here. If I like the piece, I will just put it here. If I don't like it, I will just go and nipple a little bit around. Play around with the, you have to get just the point of it. And just play around and get the pieces that I'm looking for. So you can play around with this kind of work as much as you like. Here I can use a little bit glue and I can have it here and place it somewhere here where I like it. And you can continue in this way all the way around until you reach the design that you wish. After it's finished, this type of mosaic, I'm going to just grout it. And I can use the way that I will buy it from the store, the color, but I can make my own color for the grout, and I will show you how you can do it. So I'm going to continue with the rest of the project. So here I have the parts already with the mosaic dried on the way that I liked it. Now to complete the project, I have here grout white that I changed the color in this kind of Tuscany brick color using those two other colors, which is like an orange pumpkin and a red. So I dropped some of the color in a white grout and I got this color. So I'm using like a plastic from a lid, half of it, and I will just smear the pot with the grout, and as you can see, it's a consistency as a very thick yogurt, and that goes very well between the crevices that I have here in a mosaic. So I will do this for all of them. I will let them dry until they will get on top of it like a haze. That means that I can come after and clean with a dry cloth. And that is pretty much the part for the pots. I will continue for the bottom part of my project that I will show you later. And I will show you how you can make a bigger pot, a larger one, and you can use chicken wire to reinforce it. So getting back to you. So here is the finish of the project that I mentioned, and again I'm very pleased the way that looks. And as you can see, I have used two large pots at the top of the fence, and I created an arch over where I will grow beans. And here underneath I have the other two smaller ones that I'm growing just flowers. And at the bottom I have the big large three of them. And of course I'm growing flowers as well, because here is a very sunny place and I love to see the colors on the fence with the mosaic and the flowers as well. So as a suggestion, if you have a space that it's small but you don't like the way that looks, or you think that you can enhance it, you can just create a little bit mosaic, this kind or any other kind, and definitely is going to make the place absolutely looking better. So if you have like small pots that you can get rid of them, or you need to just reuse them, just try to create those small pots, mosaic, and definitely you will find a place in your garden where you can just place them. So if you need more inspiration, like ideas for your garden and not only, of course, you can check please my channel, where you will find like cement or mosaic or gardening or cooking or 3D wall art projects that you can get inspired from them. So again, it was a very good way for me to spend my time and to calm my mind doing this project. Probably for you it's going to work in the same way. It's like a therapeutical way of living the life, and I'm hoping that you are pleased as well with this kind of project, the way I am. I'm hoping that you have a very good day. Thank you very much for watching this video. Goodbye.